glucose level in the body is regulated by the islets of Langerhans, spherical glands located around pancreatic ducts. They are comprised of beta cells that secrete insulin, alpha cells which secrete glucagon, and several other endocrine cell types. Type 1 diabetes is caused by the loss of the insulin-secreting beta cells. Islet transplantation from cadaveric donors can cure the disease, but donor scarcity requires finding alternative sources. In vitro generation of islets from human embryonic stem cells could serve as an alternative. To enable their production, scientists at the Harvard Stem Cell Institute determined how islets form during embryonic development. In mice, islets start forming around the 13th day of pregnancy. At this time, the core of the developing pancreas is a network of epithelial tubes, or cords. The cord cells divide. Inhibition of Notch signaling induces some of the daughter cells to express neurogenin 3, and these cells start differentiating towards an endocrine fate. As the differentiating endocrine progenitors leave the epithelial cord, neurogenin expression decreases and pan-endocrine genes such as chromogranin A are turned on. Cells leaving the cords maintain cell-to-cell contacts. As more cells leave the cord, they push the earlier cells outward and form a peninsula, which will later on form the islet. The first cells to exit the cords turn on glucagon and become alpha cells. Because they were the first cells to bud out, these alpha cells appear at the periphery. About a day later, insulin-producing cells start to appear in increasing numbers. Because these beta cells originate from later progenitors, they are closer to the peninsula base. In the following days, more cells leave the cords and join the peninsulas. Adjacent peninsulas may fuse, and the peninsulas grow. As birth approaches, the production rate of new progenitors wanes. Peninsula growth is now driven by division of the differentiated hormonal cells. The initial architecture of the peninsula is maintained in the sphere, and so alpha cells appear as a mantle around a core of beta cells. Peninsulas appear along much of the cords and can be found as a continuous necklace that will later break into individual islets. During the entire process, the forming islets are vascularized. The islets are now ready to sense the amount of glucose in the blood and react by secreting insulin and other hormones into the bloodstream.